Welcome to the It's Dumb Money YouTube channel, where we give you all the intel and data that you need to not only establish relationships with the banks, but also improve your credit profile. Today, I've got something really special for you. I've got about 35, 36 or so resources where you can go check out and get a soft pull inquiry. Okay, just a soft pull, not a hard pull, on various tools from credit cards to lines of credit. And I'm going to cover, I think one of them could be considered an installment loan. But yeah, 35 or 36 soft inquiry, no hard pull banks that you can see if you qualify for one of their products. Pretty cool, right? So this should be plenty, by the way. Also understand that we're going to cover everything from the big banks all the way down to those who are building credit. And I'm going to kind of give my input on a lot of these as we go along. This video might be a little bit longer. So again, you know, you can tune in to parts of it or watch the whole thing if you're really interested. Also too, there'll be a resource link underneath where you see on the screen now. This will be updated for you, but there'll be literally everything that we cover in this video. Last thing I want to say is that they tend to change these sites from time to time. So when you go to them, you might not see this, or they might have closed it down for a couple months. Banks are constantly changing their strategy with how they do outbound marketing. Just understand that if you go to these down the road, if you watch this video, you know, a year from now, the URL might be different, and we'll try and keep those updated as much as possible, and or they might just not be offering a pre-qual offer anymore. This is what you essentially call a soft inquiry or a pre-approval or a pre-qualification offer, where you get to fill in your information. They do not do a hard pull, and they tell you if they're going to give you one of their products or not. Let's start off at the top. Capital One. They recently added the Saver One card that was not in there before. Usually this for the longest time was just for rebuilding your credit, which the Quicksilver One and Platinum cards fall into. They also have the Saver One now, which is great. So you fill out this form and you see if you pre-qualify. Now I can tell you that first and foremost, Capital One pulls all three bureaus when they do a hard pull. So if you do get pre-approved and then you go on to get it, especially with these cards, considering they're credit builders, there is a very high chance you will be approved. But keep in mind that it'll be a hard pull on all three bureaus, which is awful. Also, too, they take a fairly low credit score. I mean, I believe I was approved when I had a 560 or 580. I still had derogatories on my record. I had a BK on my record still. So they're very flexible with this card. But again, it's great if you've got derogs and issues on your account, right? Okay, next, Chase. Probably one of the best banks next to American Express that you can get into. And this will see if you're pre-approved for anything on Chase. Next, Discover. They've had this form open probably the longest. A lot of banks, they'll run this and then they'll get rid of it. They'll run it, get rid of it. And this is by far one of the longest running pre-approval forms I've seen. And this is for the Discover IT, various different ones, the cash, the rewards, secured, student, and I believe they've got a couple others. Okay, next up is American Express. Really simple. It's defaulting to my stuff here. But if you just come up here to cards, check for pre-qualified credit card offers, it will take you to that page and you'll be able to pre-qual. If you're an existing member, you'll be able to pre-qual in a different way. And I'm going to be covering that in detail in the definitive guide to American Express credit cards. You can look for that on the channel. But yeah, American Express by far considered the best bank in terms of getting a credit card because high balances, lots of rewards, etc. You can see if you qualify for a American Express. They also, it goes back and forth, but they will also sometimes run a pre-qual for a business American Express credit cards. So you just gotta dig through the site and check back every once in a while and you'll see. So here's a great example of one that they tend to, they go up and they go down, they go up and they go down, and that would be Citibank. See if I can get this to reload here. And I keep this link up all the time because before you know it, this will be back and you'll be able to fill out the form and see if you're pre-approved or pre-qualified. But as you can see right now, they don't offer that. Another one that stopped offering it recently was HSBC. So there used to be a button right here that said, see if you pre-qualify. That has been removed. So right now it's just going straight to applications, it looks like. So again, I just keep these in rotation. You can check on them from time to time. If you are interested in HSBC, come back and take a look. Bank of America, the next one, for some reason, it's blocking my VPN, and so it won't even load, but I'll give the link. Again, it'll be in the resources below, and you'll be able to go through. The only issue with Bank of America is that a lot of times it will qualify you. It'll say you're pre-approved for this card, but the chances of you getting that card are pretty low, okay? So I'd be looking for other Confluence and Datapoint to check out before you go and pull the trigger on Bank of America. That'll be covered again in a separate video on the channel as well. BB&T, I absolutely love this offer. I'm gonna give you a huge piece of insight here in just a sec, but yeah, you just see if you're pre-qualified. It only covers 17 states at this time, unless something recently is changed. But another huge thing is that when you pre-qualify for one, you pre-qualify for all three and it doesn't pull additional hard hits and you can actually get all three cards. I've had somebody, now granted this was before COVID, I had somebody get all three cards, $6,500 balance on each one. I don't know if that's still the case, but just keep in mind that could happen. And so, you know, do your own research there. Regions, they recently changed this. Only existing Regions customers may check to see if they're pre-approved for credit cards, which is great. Regions covers 15 states. I believe that's still true. You can double check these things. By the time you're watching this video, it might've changed and this message might have changed or be gone. You have to be already doing banking with them and have coverage in one of those states. Wells Fargo, all we do is come here and we look for pre-selected offers right here. And then you'll be able to tell if you get pre-selected for something on Wells Fargo. I have zero experience using Wells Fargo personally. US Alliance. What's interesting about this one is that if once you go through this pre-qualification, this will pre-qual you on all kinds of other things like lines of credit loans and car loans, I believe. Pretty interesting. FNBO, I believe it's First National Bank of Omaha, correct? And this is the one that everyone wants to get. Yep. Everyone was trying to figure out what was going on with this because there seems to be some discrepancies between the getting pre-qualification offers and actually getting approved, which maybe we'll cover that in another video, but you can definitely check out and see if you pre-qualify here. Next is BBVA. This looks like they might have made a change here to these pre-qual pages recently, and or it's not liking my VPN, so I'm not sure which, but they basically had a different pre-qual page for each card that they offered. This first one is the rewards credit card, it's supposed to be, and the second one is supposed to be the clear points credit card. You see both of them are defaulting to something went wrong. So either these pages are just temporarily down, which has happened before, or they've been permanently changed. So you see the product ID is different. We got 05 and 03. So again, you could see if you pre-qualified for either one of those cards. BBVA used to be exclusively to just a couple states, Colorado being one of them. And I believe they've been recently opening that up. But yeah, you see it operates in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 with branches, but has ATMs throughout. Next, this is a really popular one, is the Apple credit card. Used to only be able to see if you pre-qualified through the wallet app on your iPhone, but now you can in fact come here and just click on the apply now on the Apple site. I'll have the link below and it'll make you log in. And then from there you can go through and do the application. Now I will tell you, having an Apple card, that you will need to set it up and activate it and add it to your wallet app and Apple Pay. So at least to activate it, you'll have to set it up there, but you can log in and manage it all online. It's not, you know, payments and everything isn't done through the phone. You don't have to do that. You can do it online. Next, let's get into some kind of like fintech stuff and get outside of the traditional banks into some of the new products and programs. The first one is Deserve. This used to be just an EDU card for students, but I see that they're really branching out. They have two cards right now by the looks of it, and it looks like they're co-branding a third card, which I'll cover in just a second. It says here, see if you're approved without a negative impact to your credit. So this is new as well. From the last time I came here, they would just do a real soft poll inquiry and you just had to fill out your data, but now it looks like it wants you to connect. The one that I believe is a spinoff or a co-brand is, if you look here at the URL, it's Bank Mobile Credit, which is a new one. I haven't heard much about this, but it's cards.bankmobile.deserve.com. So that is absolutely a Deserve co-brand. There it is right there. Bank Mobile Credit MasterCard is issued by Customers Bank. So this is issued by a different bank. So good to know. If you maybe don't get accepted here, you can get accepted here. I'm constantly looking at what bank backs the card or the offer. Prime example is, this is Petal. This was another one that was designed for, I think, like kids and students that were just getting, you know, kind of going through college and didn't have any credit at all. They have two cards now. Not really sure the difference between the two. Standard APRs for somebody with no credit, little credit. And they're backed by Web Bank. This is a big bank, by the way, that backs a lot of cards. So understand that if you're going through these pre-quals and not getting pre-qualed for this, they back a lot of new fintech stuff. So keep that in mind. If you don't get pre-qualed for one, you're not gonna get pre-qualed for others. Upgrade.com, this is the Upgrade card, which they're constantly making changes to and adding different products to the suite. This is a pretty interesting offer because it reports as an installment loan. They call it a credit line, but you get a credit card with it. So I know that there's a lot there to digest. And when you make payments, you get actually 1.5% cash back. I know that they've got some sign-up bonus stuff. I saw it on my Credit Karma, where you get a $200 bonus of some sort after you make a certain amount of payments, I believe. But this is an interesting offer. This is very similar to the PayPal Loan Builder process. So you go through the process, it will soft poll inquiry, it'll make you do a selfie photo, give front and back of ID, then you gotta do proof of income on this one. You've already been approved by this point, soft approved, and they've already told you what they're gonna give you offer-wise and the APR. Then you start uploading docs, very similar to the older Loan Builder program on PayPal. Then you accept the offer and finalize it based off what additional information that they need. I do believe that they try and call you a couple times as well, so just make sure that you're, you know, You put in a real phone number that you can answer. A lot of people absolutely love this because the credit lines can be very, very big. Next is payoff. Not really a credit card offer. It's not really a personal loan offer. It's just a debt consolidation offer. So gonna slide this one in here. This goes directly to, you know, pay off all of your credit cards. Get you just making one payment, which is great for a lot of people, especially if you kind of worked yourself into a hole through the last year or so with the economic situation. Okay, now let's pivot into rebuilding credit. Maybe I got some DROGs in my account. Maybe I've been rebuilding and I've removed bankruptcies and so on and so forth. And now I'm looking to rebuild credit. That's where things like Merit Bank come into play. These are good cards. I mean, I think you get approved for $2,000 or $2,500. I don't believe there's much room for CLIs or credit limit increases. But again, you can come and check this one out, especially if you're rebuilding. Next, Avant. This reminds me of, at first I thought that I was typing this wrong because there's another one called Aspire, which sends out letters. So once, as long as you're not opted out in any sort of way, you'll start to get letters from Aspire and Merrick, as well as other subprime providers. But Avant is new to me, and they will do a soft pull, and they do personal loans and credit cards. You see $300 to $1,000 credit line. I doubt these things really, you get a lot of credit limit increase on this kind of thing. It's really just meant to do one thing, and it's like a baby step above a secured credit card, so keep that in mind. Now let's cover some really, really subprime cards, which these remind me of like Credit One, the Indigo cards, and the cards that your Merrick Bank, not Merrick, but it's something like that. First One Bank or something like that. They're the ones that you're always getting offered in the back end of Credit Karma and Experian. But you'll see that, I mean, these are ones with very high rates, 25 to 29% variable and $75 to $99 annual fees. And it's crazy because, like, even though it reports to, you know, all three bureaus, who cares? You're only getting between $3 to $750. After the fees and with the APR, it's very predatory. And so I just figured I'd include these in case you're bored or something and want to see. But these to me are junk. And so this is the YourSurgeCard.com. But then if you look here, it seems to be the same company, YourReflexCard.com. It looks like almost identical offers, 75 to 99, pretty similar APR, and 300 to 1,000. And again, if you're thinking that this is gonna, like, you know, you're gonna be able to get credit limit increases on these sorts of cards, you're not. Yeah, you're gonna have hard hits after you've accepted it. So I just don't think they're worth it. Credit One is one of the worst ones that you'll see. It's always brought up in the back end of, you know, my recommendations, my offers on Experian and Credit Karma, Wallet Hub, etc. You could do this one, I guess, if you wanted to. Expect the same thing. High APR rates, yearly fees, very hard to make payments, very hard to cancel. You know, just go and look at the reviews on Credit Karma and all these other sites and you'll see what I'm talking about. Next, let's pivot into vehicles and obscure, weird stuff that you really shouldn't get unless you plan on getting the thing itself. So let's start with Yamaha. This is a pre-approval. Like, you actually have to select what you want to get, like the model and the year and all that. And then, yeah, this will tell you if you pre-approve for some Yamaha-based product. Well, actually, I guess in the middle of this, we're going to kind of inject some Wells Fargo cards. So these are all Wells Fargo co-brands. We've got Cocoon by Sealy, so beds. This is a pre-approval that you can check out right here. Next, Tempur-Pedic. This was one of my very first credit card purchases. I got qualified for this and I never ended up paying it back, and it was involved in my bankruptcy. It was disgusting. But yeah, you can check to see if you pre-qualify here. Amazing beds. I will tell you that they last literally forever. And the only thing is that they also cost $2,000 to $3,000. You can check for your, see if you can get a new bed. Here is Kohl's. So Kohl's was backed by Capital One, which I thought so, and I double checked my notes, but it doesn't seem to be anymore, maybe. Maybe it still is, I don't know. I will say though that if you go through this pre-qual and it says that you're approved, I would double check the fine print to see which bank it's gonna list. Because if it is Capital One, keep in mind that you'll be hit, a hard hit on all three bureaus, which to me is just not worth it. Kohl's has got some great coupons and discounts and stuff, but that's just not worth it to me. Okay, Toyota. This is the pre-qual for that. So again, if you're not planning on buying a vehicle, probably shouldn't. This is a co-brand from Comenity Bank, which has about 90 plus credit cards that they co-brand. Keep in mind that if this is gone or you can't find this, it's probably rotated into another one of their store cards. So we do have a list on itsdumbmoney.com showing all the co-branded cards. You could just run through that list and double check. And if any of them look good, I'm sure at least one or two of them, or five, will have soft pull pre-approval like this. They tend to rotate. So every once in a while, you see it's a Victoria's Secret, or it's Toyota, or it's Lexus, or it's this one, right? So Toyota is still up at the time of this video. IKEA is also still up. This is the IKEA project card, by the way. They also have another Visa card that's separate, that's not a co-brand. This is just a store card, meaning you can only use it in the store. It's like, again, Toyota, you can only use it at Toyota. And then the third one I was mentioning here, which I actually couldn't find, so they must have recently changed, is Lexus had a pre-qual up, and that must have changed. So again, you could just go to the site and run through the list and double check all these. They seem to go off of every once in a while, they pivot and it jumps from this group to this group in terms of if they're offering pre-qual. Okay, next, Dell preferred account. Pretty straightforward. If you wanna buy Dell products, which are great products, then go through this, see if you are pre-approved and go from there. Let's jump into home improvement now. So the Lowe's Advantage, you'll just click here and see if you're pre-approved. This is the consumer card, which I know for some people, they don't really think it's that worth it to get the consumer cards on, you know, home improvement sites like this and stores like this, is because they would rather put it on a business account. But if you have zero desire to try and build up an EIN number and do all the net 30 and building up a foundation to get your account ready and looking good to get a business credit card at these stores, then just don't. And just, you know, go through and get a consumer card instead. So here's the Lowe's. Then there was one for Home Depot, but I can't find it. And I know like literally a month ago it was there. So this is another one of those ones where you just gotta keep coming back to the page and see if the pre-approvals come back. Like I said, they tend to run it at different times throughout the year. Last one I wanted to share with you is the Capital One Walmart Rewards Card. This has its own site and its own area to see if you're pre-approved, which I don't believe comes through on the other Capital One pre-approval I already showed you. This, I think, is completely different. Again, keep in mind, if you do end up getting this card, it's gonna hard hit all three for the Walmart Capital One Rewards. That's all I've got for you in this video. If you like this video, please just take a second, like, comment below if you've got other soft pull inquiry links that you've found around the internet, or if you've got something to say, got a question, comment below. Help us get this video up in the algorithms, and subscribe to the channel if you're new here and you like this sort of thing. Hit the bell notification. Be on the lookout for more videos coming soon.